Hello, I'm Liviu Balan, and today I will speak about the Git LS3 command. So, let's get started. First, let's understand what the Git LS3 command is. The Git LS3 command lists the content of a given tree object, like what /bin/ls-a does in the current working directory. When you work with the Git LS3, remember that the git ls3 command works with tree-ish IDs. Tree-ish is a term that refers to any identifier that ultimately leads to a subdirectory tree. In order to understand better the git ls3 command, let's see some examples. First, as you can see here, I'm on a terminal with a git repo inside of my current working directory. If I type git log, you'll see the log of my commits inside of my current git repository. If I type git status, you'll see that I'm on my master branch with nothing to commit and the working directory is clean. Next, I will open another tab into my current terminal and let's see some examples of git ls3 usage. First, I will type git ls3 and then, in order to specify a tree-ish ID, I will enter the head pointer. So, if I hit the enter key, as you can see, here you will see a listing very closer to ls-a. If I type ls-al, you will see a similar listing, but this one refers to the ls-al refers to the file inside of my current file system, and this one refers to the files inside of my current working directory relative to my repository. Okay, now if I type git ls3 and then master, here as you can see I'm seeing the same output because now the master and the head points to the same location. If I want to see a specific tree-ish ID, I can type git ls-3 and then I can copy a part of this commit ID, or I can specify the full commit ID like this one. And what this command is showing is in this case, the content of this directory, which is a tree object, as you can see here. In the context of git ls3, tree means a directory and blob means a regular file. Okay, now let's see some examples relative to paths. If I type git ls3 head again and hit enter, you will see the files inside of my current repo of my current repository relative to the current working directory. Now, if I want to see a specific resource, let's say I want to see what is inside of the CSS directory, I will type git lst head space CSS. Hit enter, and as you can see, now I am able to see the CSS directory, but I am not able to see the content inside of my CSS directory. If I want to do this, all I have to do is to specify a trailing slash for the CSS directory. Now, if I hit enter, I am able to see the content of the CSS directory in a git lst format. If you want to convince yourself what is inside of my CSS directory, I can type lscss and you will see that style and theme.css are inside of this directory. Okay, so as you saw, when you don't specify a trailing slash, even if you are referring to a directory, this lists the CSS directory, and when you specify a trailing directory, this lists content inside of the directory. Now, some useful options when you use the git lst command are the minus r, which means a recursive showing into subtrees. For example, if you type git lst head, you will see only the level 1 files and directories. If you want to recursively show all the files and directories, you have to specify the minus r option. Now, if I hit the enter key, you will see that instead of showing CSS directories, for example, it's showing me style.css and theme.css located into my CSS directory. If I also specify the minus t option, this show three entries even when going to recurse them. Now, if I hit the enter key, you will see that besides of the files inside of directories, you will see the directory also. If you want to show object size of blob files entries, you will have to use the minus l option. Now, if I use the minus l option for the head pointer, you will see that only for the files and not directories, the size of the files are shown. Remember that this is for only for blob or file entries. If I use the minus r option to show the files and directories recursively, you will see that for files the size are shown, the size is shown, and for the and when you see a zero size, this means that the file is empty. Now, let's see some useful tree-ish IDs in action. If I use git ls tree command and use the head pointer, now if I hit the enter key, you will see the files into the root of my project. If I use the minus r option Also, I will see all the files. Now, if at the end of the head pointer I specify a caret operator, this will refer to the parent of the head pointer. So, instead of showing me all the files, this will not show all the resources. And this is because if you examine the git log here, you will see that on the previous command, the file-1.txt and file-2.txt located inside of my txt directory weren't exists. So, here, file-1.txt and file-2.txt inside of my txt directory were shown, but when I refer to the parent of my current head pointer, these resources weren't shown. I can refer to the parent of the head pointer, and here I will not see the files inside of my JS directory. As you can see here, I am able to see the JS files, but here I am not able to see them. And instead of using a lot of characters, I can use the tilde and then the levels of forwarding. Now, if I hit the Enter key, I will see the same output. So, the command here with a caret with a caret character backs one commit, with two carets back two commits, and with the tilde 2 value back two commits also. If you want to see the options that the git ls3 provides you, you can use man git ls3 in order to access the git manual page. Here you will see all the options that git ls3 is providing you. And if you want a specific option, you can try it. So this is how the git ls3 works. If you want to learn more about Git, about web technologies, you can check out my tutorials on YouTube and also visit my website liviubalan.com. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.